at level 4, and since most of the team, most of the hero picks here are mostly team fight oriented. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I don't think Team SMG can really punish them in the early game. I mean, maybe Grok and Cho with
the Selena as well.
With the Selena, yeah, I think level 2 is around where Team SMG want to be aggressive. But level 1, I don't expect them to invade, actually.
Well, let's just see whether they're willing to take this risk, because you know what they say? You risk everything to win everything.
I don't know, maybe this risk feels like there are calculated risks, but this one might be a little too much to handle here, especially if you are playing the Selena. Like, yes, you want to get to level 2 as quickly as possible, but to invade and look to hit level 2 off of your enemy's jungle buffs, that's really, really risky here.
Yeah. Oh my god, still really love Fight Mali's really making use of that way of nature. Since it did get a slight damage increase from the last patch as well, going back and forth, clearing the waves, everyone's just being normal.
Yeah, I don't think much is going to be happening as of right now here. You can see that Mali is making sure that he is keeping tabs on where exactly Todok members are going to be. And you can see E1 as well. They have full control over this bottom side. And you can see Cho trying to take away the red buff as soon as possible. But unfortunately, he doesn't have the best clear speed here. So now Todok will be in full control over this bottom side. I would expect Team SMG to respond to this.
Yeah, but still, like you said as well, they're slowly responding to it. As you can see on the minimap, you see Grok and Sonic, I saw it coming from the way back. E1, no chance, had to use the perfect map to try to get out of that situation. Will be able to get out of it as well, but without losing a couple or without paying a certain price for it.
Yeah. Moon is in a lot of trouble. He took a full brunt of damage from iSonic once he has marked him. Unfortunately, Wakano, that Abyssal Arrow landing perfectly, getting a good catch. And this is what Team SMG want. Now they got the ball slowly rolling. They need to put their foot on the gas pedal.
Yep, stuff is still going to. Let's check it out towards the top side as well, because we already see like instantly damage or X-ray in this case has to slowly fall back and get a couple of fighters for himself here. Or might we just heal up a little bit, as looks like they're going to be going for a lane swap actually.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think this lane swap is a really good idea because they want to control different parts of the map. Now that they know that red buff is gone, there's no real reason to actually do anything, and they can safely assume that blue was taken away. iSonic going to get another free pick here with that Abyssal Arrow. No need to hype that up because that was just a very sad situation for
E1. It's already sort of like expected as well. Well, because the fact that once you have a Selena, you really need to try to be very aggressive. But anyway, Neo, no chance gonna flick out, will actually be able to get out with just a very slim of HP.
Yeah, this really is a very heavily 1v1 lane. X-Ray taking advantage of his level 4 to try and punish Neo. Oh, once again, iSonic getting a great hit onto Chiku here. Chiku doesn't really care about it overall because he's going to go to 50% HP and then back up to 60, literally walking away.
The iSonic has been really, really on point with those Abyssal Arrows by far during this last 2 minutes of the game here. But let's just see whether he's able to fully utilize for the team later on towards the mid game, because now everyone's already hitting level 4s already. Everyone's getting all their ultimates out. Let's just see how aggressive they're going to be later on.
I think the big ticket ultimates has to be E1 here. He needs to hit that level 4 to make some big impact, and the same as Moon. Both of them can make significant plays, quick rotations with Moon's ultimate, as well as the Fatal Links coming in from E1 can really change the course of a fight. So again, very important they hit level 4 here. They both hit level 4, and now they're going to be sitting right on top of the neutral objective that they have been looking for, and that is the turtle. Team SMG either need to respond to this or look to take economy away from Toda.
By the way, topside, we see X-Ray just kept applying pressure. I love the fact that he knows his team is doing turtle. He also spotted out some of the members towards that river. He just doesn't want it to leave his sight at all, giving out much information because they know, you know, sure, they have a team fight potential, so, but they do not really want to commit it just yet. But anyway, where the dragon going to be hit on top of X-Ray here? Actually going to be bombing out the ultimate alongside with the multi-site, doing quite the amount of damage, but there's just too many CC coming from the side here of Team SMG. They're going to be able to take a clean win or a clean kill off X-Ray.
Yeah, I don't know. They've been using a lot of Mr. Muscle these days, and apparently it's been working out really, really nicely here. They netted themselves one turret off of a small mistake coming out of X-Ray here, who kind of just disrespected the Cho a little bit, assuming that nobody was going to be there on top side.
Is there anyway, Neo? Coming in to see, trying to back him up, Mali as well, but Mali just taking a little bit too much damage! Jeez! Sorry, no, Mali's out. It's just so much damage.
And they've tried to pull one more back into the fray. They are able to get 2-4-0 there. Really nicely done coming in from E1, but the damage from Moon, my god. He looks comfortable. For once in a very long time, Moon looks very comfortable playing this Lo Yi.
And the thing is, just so much amount of burst as well. We also saw in the previous game as well how well that Aura Fire really utilized that Lo Yi. And now in this case, it's going to be the same thing by E1. My god!
Oh, that Dark Spirit coming in from Moskov was a little too close for comfort, but E1 refuses to give that kill over.
Dude, that was a little bit too close for comfort if you ask me as well. But anyway, Chiku trying to do as much damage, as much presence as possible with that Uranus going with the Ionic Edge, and especially with the Transcendent Ward as well.
Yeah, he has to keep control, and getting this Lethal Wanderer is just going to allow the team to be more aggressive here, because once they take a little bit of poke damage, they're like, oh, all right, and, you know, heal up with the Lethal Wanderer, rotate back into the top side and continue the push. Well,
gotta be careful. Ionic. I'm pretty sure Ionic has a very good guess of what's going on. He's pretty sure spotted out maybe that he doesn't really want to face check that bush. Mali going to the top side, trying to clear out the way to see whether he can save his tier 1 tower. Tower goes down, maybe he's still a little bit too long. Have to commit that wall charge. But once committing that wall charge as well, Turtle, they, on the side of Team Turtle, they will then realize they don't really have a wall charge to commit towards this Turtle fight, should it happen.
Yeah, and the more that Torak is able to take, you know, these tower objectives away from Team SMG, the more likely they will have control over the map and not have to worry about Ionic as much. So at this point in time, Ionic did get a bit of a lead for himself, but I don't think it's enough to stop Torak from taking these towers.
Yo, my god, dude. The Abyssal Arrow is just happening all over the place. Ewando! Oh! Flick is in! Coming with the Fatal Link! Actually falls in the back off and instantly flick out that situation. But this is exactly what Lancelot was actually waiting for. Ani was waiting for this kind of opportunity. But on the other side, they had to be careful of Smooth because of amount of damage. My god! Pumping on the string! Making them dance according to his own tune! Chico trying to bash with the Uranus, but Smooth wants a couple more and gets the double kill for himself. But on the other side, Ani definitely trying to get a couple of trades for himself. But there's just too much action happening all over the place. And Fall 5 men will fall to the side of Team SMG.
That was a very big fight for Team SMG here, as Torak taking a fight that was looking really, really good, but a great response coming out from Team SMG. Unfortunately, E1 was only able to catch, if I remember, Ionic as well as Neo, both of which had to use their flickers instantaneously to get out of there to stop the follow-up coming in from Torak. And then that's when they started to break apart the fight. They were looking for many different angles. And Anip, the problem with Lancelot as a hyper carry, yes, he does a lot of damage, but he's so dependent on his cooldown.
Yeah, and also just need to focus as well on the side here of Bonzi as well. Literally, the timing and his positioning was literally everything. He already knew major ultimates was already popping out. A lot of flickers and hero spells were also committing to try to catch onto Ionic and Neo. And instantly, once he got this information, he just literally came casually from where his tier 1 tower was actually at, came from the round back, and instantly just picked up members one by one. And under the thing is, even though he's getting a couple of kills for himself at the back line, he then realized, like, I'm losing my reinforcement because my back line is being hit harder than how I'm hitting their back line.
Yeah, and I think, you know, they have Torak has to identify the Team SMG, right? They're not looking to play the slow game. They're looking to burst down as many people as quickly as possible, because you can see that even Neo himself has the killing spree. He has gone into the Assassin Emblems. He wants to deal damage.
Yep. Still, E1 definitely trying to see if he can get another opportunity for himself, but I rather recommend he doesn't, because now a majority of his main damage team is actually really there with him. Chiku still trying to hold out this lane, but going up against an Angela is definitely not going to be very easy for him.
Yeah, Angela, as of right now, Bonzi is doing a really good job. He also has 3 kills under himself, so he's able to kind of buffer the time that he scales off of the game by buying some really great items like the Necklace of Durant, a very great utility item to stop the healing coming in from X-Ray, as well as on it from that spell vamp itself. Chiku gonna walk away. He doesn't really care about this. E1 coming in looking for a major play here, but he's getting punished significantly. Smooth! Wow, that knockback was so important for him, because you can clearly see that E1 even committing to the flicker as well to try and make that play.
And sadly, he was not able to connect it either. Chiku trying to run away from his side, but the amount of damage just coming up from Moskow here on Smooth, just really being a real smooth criminal. And on the other side, Ionic just landing those Abyssal Arrows, and the thing is, it's all pretty much predicted as well, because he knows teammates is going to rotate towards his bot lane. It's very easy to tell which lane they're going to be coming from, how they're going to be walking as well.
Yeah, this Angela pick looking to be very, very significant for Team SMG, because Smooth now doesn't have to worry about too much.
Oh my God.
The sustain X-Ray pops his ultimate to try and hope make something happen. Oh, he gets chucked out by that power of nature, but unfortunately, it ain't going to be enough. And Smooth, seeing the opportunity to catch someone and clip them against the wall, takes it, bites, and makes sure that Torak doesn't come back from that.
Dude, absolutely amazing. Like, just if I want to break it down a little bit more towards what happened towards that mid lane as well, is that you saw the Grog, even though we did say a lot of these heroes able to blink or cross over walls or cliffs or terrains, right? But the thing is, the Grog put the wall. We know that Thomas has the skill, this Chasm Trample, able to allow it to jump over the wall. But the thing is this, it's so planned out. He saw the Abyssal Arrow coming. It's literally all set for it. He had no choice to go away from the wall, despite he knows he can go over. But if he does try, he will get hit by the Abyssal Arrow, or he get caught by Smooth. He had no choice but to go another, a more longer route to go back to the base here. It's like it's picked off.
Yeah, there's nothing much you could really do in that particular situation. So a great play coming in from Team SMG. Can they keep this snowball up? They've already got the Lord pushing down with Lord empowered minions, and I think they're trying to sync it up as of yet. However, you can see that certain members are slightly out of position, anticipating that Torak will try and make a move on this bot side.
Yeah, anyway, Chico would receive a lot amount of damage, but we know it's Uranus. Uranus is definitely going to be able to regen him back up, but next fight, next team fight will actually really decide on how well this game is actually going to be. Is it going to be going to the side of Team SMG or Team Torak? Because right now, Team SMG is definitely in the lead here, but still coming into the ranks. Man, Chico gets stuck towards the wall as well, trying to back up with his concentration, trying to keep him as alive as possible. They were able to clear up the Lord, but now they had to deal with multiple lanes and also a couple of heroes without their ultimates here.
Yeah, and this is going to be some really big resources here. However, Moon, this is his time to shine because he does have some great AoE and wave clearing options. He just can't afford to get caught by any of the CC being provided from Team SMG. They rotate to the bot side. E1 gets an amazing Fatal Link onto two members for Neo as well as Moon. They get them both, and now this is going to be a free fight for Torak as they're chasing them one by one. You can see Isonic, he's trying to use the Abyssal Arrows to allow his team to escape from such a deadly position. The TP coming in with the ultimate from Moon, try and catch us one more. Bolti still alive as well as Mali. They're gonna chase him halfway across the map. Bolti gonna be shut down for the side of Adip, and this is the turnaround that Torak was looking for.
No, this is amazing as well because they literally knew that the fact that if they even let even one more member leave back to base to actually regen for themselves, then that's gonna be heavy. They're gonna be facing a little bit more concentration, a little bit more resistance as they try to take down this mid tower for themselves. Although Bolti is gonna be coming on at exactly 60 seconds, but will 60 seconds be enough? Because Team Torak, seems like they really want to try to end this now and right here now. Mali trying to hold out the fort with the wall chance, but we're able to get the kill for himself. Followed by Isonic trying to follow up with the trade. Troll doing his best, and instantly Team Torak has to back up a little bit of overcommitment that with such low HP team is here.
Yeah, they kind of botched that up because they should have set.
No!
X-Ray is going to hit the chopping block as well. Chico should be absolutely A-okay here. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to get the recall off in time.
Oh,
ended up dying
God.
In base. And another one bites the dust as Team SMG replying back. Chico, he has to somehow just hold the lanes for as long as possible.
Yo, this is... Oh, yeah. Like, from an initial advantage they had, I think they just a little bit overstepped their commitment here. Wall gonna be used as well. Sadly, E1 gets caught up against the wall with the wall chat a lot. Damage a lot, CC, but Fatal Link will still be able to connect as well. But sadly, there's no follow-up, no damage enough to actually clear up the rest of the team here. And game one of this match one will go to the side here, Team SMG.
Woo! Team SMG take a game off of the previous runner-ups of the M1 tournament itself. Very well done for Team SMG.